Hi, how are you, and thanks for joining. Today we're going to review the different four preheaters that JBC Tools has. All of our preheaters go to the max temperature of 482F. That's around 250C. Then, all of our preheaters are convection preheaters. Okay, you have to keep in mind that's the technology for our preheaters. There's other preheaters in the market that are IR preheaters. That's what you achieve with that is that you have more protection in each board. If you want, we're going to review a little of the main specs of each preheater, and then we'll go more in depth. This one is the PHNK. This is one of our novelties. Okay, you have to keep in mind that the heating surface width is around 2 times 4. Okay, you have to keep in mind also it's one zone, so you can only heat one zone, and then also it has 2 thermocouples. Then we go to the small preheater. The small preheater is the PHSK. This one here instead, you have 4 thermocouples, so 2 thermocouples more. You also, the heating surface will be around 5 by 5. And you have 2 different zones, so you can heat up either zone A or zone B or both at the same time. Then we go to the large preheater. The large preheater is the PHBK. This one here is also as well 2 zones, so you can heat up both, same as the small one, and has 4 thermocouples as well. However, the heating surface of this one is 14 times 11. And finally, we have the PHXK, that's the large one, the extra large one, okay? That's the heating surface is 20 by 24, and instead of 4 thermocouples, we have 8 thermocouples. If you want now, I'm going to explain more in depth the different preheaters that we have, but especially this one. And also, just to keep in mind, we have, I don't know if you can see it here, we have different stands, and each one of them, it's custom made for the base as well. This one here, for example, the PHB, you can adapt the height depending on the board. This one here is the PHBK. This one is the large preheater. Just to give you a little recap, you have the zone A, zone B, or you can connect both of them. You can also clamp your board depending on how big it is, the shape it has as well. If the board is bigger than the stand, you can lay the board on top of these ESD buttons. Also, we have 4 different thermocouples where, thanks to them, you will gather off more control. Probably you cannot see it here with the camera, you can appreciate it, but you can see that little by little, the temperature is gradually increasing. Okay? What you're achieving here is total control in every single aspect of the board. My advice is always have at least 2 thermocouples, one in the secondary source area, the other one on the primary. Why? Because then you're achieving more control in underneath and on top. As well, if you go and click here, for example, you go to the general menu, you can see that here you can either select Celsius or Fahrenheit. Okay? Depends on the country that you're living in. Also, the maximum temperature is 250. That was the 482 that I mentioned before. And just to give you a little overview as well about it, this preheater has 3 different modes. You have the temperature mode, the power mode, and the profile mode. The temperature mode will be the one that I just showed. It's the one that you can select the temperature and control that temperature perfectly. The power mode will be that you can select an X amount of power of the preheater. And the profile mode will be that you can create a profile. You can create until 20 profiles with this one. And the nice thing of this is that if you don't want to use this thermocouple, some people think it's annoying, is that you can take it out, put the teaching mode inside the profile mode, and create and replicate the same profile once again and again and again. So you have the same profile without using thermocouple. Apart, inside of the thermocouples, not only that, it has 3 different modes. Each thermocouple has 3 different modes, okay? You have the protection mode. The protection mode would be like, for example, imagine that you're working with big board, and in certain areas there's critical components, so you don't want these components to crack to a certain temperature. So you can either select the protection mode. Imagine that you're trying to preheat the board at 150. You can select, imagine 100. You don't exceed that certain area to 100C. And if that thermocouple reaches to that temperature, the unit shuts off. On the other sense, we have the control mode. The control mode would be the one that I just showed. The moment that the board gets to 120, for example, see, it's the temperature you have select, the board will start glowing. So you will never exceed that temperature. And then the final mode will be the information mode. The information mode is only to give you some information about the temperature. That's it. Feel free to ask for a demo, and I hope to see you in another video.